In this example, we want to determine the length of this side here labeled x from the given information. This angle is 32 degrees, this angle is 26 degrees, and the length of this segment here is 1,250 feet. This is actually a fairly challenging question. We should notice right away that there are actually two right triangles here. There's this one here, and this larger right triangle here. And one of the more challenging parts about this problem is that looking at this smaller right triangle, we know the measure of this angle, but we don't know the length of any of the sides. So let's let the length of this side be equal to y. Therefore, the entire length of this side of the large right triangle would be y plus 1,250 feet. And now we'll set up two trig equations involving x and y, and then we'll have to solve them as a system of equations. We take a look at this smaller right triangle. X is the opposite side, and y is the adjacent side to the given angle. So we can say that tangent 32 degrees is equal to x divided by y. If we wanted to, we could cross multiply and say that x is equal to y times tangent 32 degrees. Now let's take a look at the larger right triangle. The tangent of 26 degrees would be equal to the ratio of the opposite side, which is x, divided by the length of this longer adjacent side, which is y plus 1,250. And again, let's go ahead and cross multiply. So here we'd have x equals tangent 26 degrees times y plus 1,250. Now notice that both of these equations involve x and y, but they're also both solved for x. So if they're both equal to x, we can set y times tangent 32 degrees equal to tangent 26 degrees times the quantity y plus 1,250, solve for y, and then perform back substitution to solve for x. So our equation is going to be y times tangent 32 degrees equals tangent 26 degrees times the quantity y plus 1,250. Let's go ahead and get an approximation for tangent 32 degrees and tangent 26 degrees. So we have approximately 0.6249. And approximately 0.4877. So if we perform this substitution, we're going to have 0.6249y equal to 0.4877 times the quantity y plus 1,250. Now, even though we have some decimals here, notice this equation only contains one variable. So now we'll go ahead and distribute and solve for y. .4877 times 1,050 is 609.625. Now we'll go ahead and subtract. So now we'll go ahead and subtract 0.4877y on both sides. This comes out to 0.1372y equals 609.625. And now we'll divide both sides by 0.1372. So y is approximately equal to this quotient, 609.625 divided by 0.1372. So y is approximately 4,443.3. But remember, our goal is to determine x. But we can use this equation here now that we have y to determine x. X is going to be approximately equal to 4,443.3 times tangent 32 degrees. So if we round to the nearest foot, x is approximately 2,776 feet.